A white-tailed eagle in the east of Scotland has successfully raised two chicks in separate nests to separate mothers. The male managed to feed its young in Angus and in Fife, flying the 90-minute journey between the two several times a day. David Shanks has more.
A large male white-tailed eagle feeding its young alongside its mate in Fife. But this amorous raptor is leading a double life. Staff at the RSPB were stunned when they discovered this male, called Turquoise Z, had a secret second love nest.
Well, what's happened is we've got two different nests, one in Fife, one in Angus. They're about 28 miles apart with a different female in each, and he's gone back and forth between them all season long, and they've managed to fledge a chick from each nest, which is the first time that that's happened in Scotland that we know of. Every time they've attempted it previously, it's failed off on the west coast, and it's very rare anyway, so for them to succeed for the first time is quite extraordinary.
The white-tailed eagle is Britain's largest bird of prey, and Turquoise Z would have had to find a kilo of food every day for each of his nests from key feeding spots like here at the beach by Tensmere Forest, meaning a nervous few months for local nest watchers.
Yeah. We've gone through this year, it's been a roller coaster of emotions, and at the start of the year we were feeling quite confident. We knew this pair, we'd been watching them for quite a while, we thought we knew their behaviour. And then the male disappeared and we thought maybe he was abandoning the nest in Fife, but as it turns out he's managed to survive, and the females as well have managed, because they've had to do extra work, each of them, to feed the chicks.
This week marks 10 years since the white-tailed eagle was reintroduced here on the east coast of Scotland. And across the country as a whole, it's been a fantastic success story, now with over 100 breeding pairs. And if they all show the same enthusiasm as Turquoise Z, there could be many more to come. David Shanks, STV News.